كن شهيد. I am with you witnessing it. وما يعزب عن ربك من مثقال ذرة في السماوات ولا في الأرض. But not an atom worth of grain that is hidden from your Lord, whether it's in heavens or in earth, whether it's smaller than that or greater, but all in a great clear record. ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. Why does Allah say He brings the awliya of Allah after this ayah? To tell you that the awliya of Allah are those who understood this ayah and lived by it. If you understood this and lived by it, you are then among the awliya of Allah. لا خوف عليهم. They shall not fear. What shall they fear? They're in His kingdom. What can happen to him that is beyond His control or above His power? Nothing. You are with your loving Creator. وإذا العناية, the poet says, وإذا العناية لاحظتك عيونها نام فالحوادث كلها. He says, if the care of Allah is after you, is looking at you, then sleep anywhere you are. Don't worry, sleeping in the desert, sleeping whatever you, because in the old days, sleeping in the desert, you might be killed. No, sleep anywhere. For anything that will happen is a matter of safety. You are safe. I'll finish with this, because Asr is going to come soon, they said. So I want to take you back real quick, again, to the hadith of Sayyidina Ja'far bin Abi Talib. When he first went to Africa, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commissioned him to go to Africa. This hadith is Hasan fi Babi. I can't tell you how important this hadith is for one simple reason. Why? Because it tells us what the early Sahaba, how did they see Islam? What was Islam to them? Because oftentimes we're confused of what Islam is. What is Islam? Something I inherited from my parents? Something I was born with? Some system I just gotta do so I can be okay? And that's when Umm Salama narrates the hadith. And Umm Salama is one of the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. الكريمة بنت الكريم. أم سلمة كريمة, and her father was خزيمة from بني مخزوم. Her father used to be nicknamed زاد الراكب. زاد الراكب, which means what? If you ever happen to be traveling with the father of أم سلمة رضي الله عنها, he suffices you from bringing anything for the travel. No matter how many people. That was his generosity. Culture, he said, it's about the cultural values. Cultural values. So that people in Quraysh nicknamed him Zadur Rakib, the sustenance of the traveler. You're traveling, you happen to travel with him, don't worry about sustenance. All the sustenance he'll bring, he'll insist you use none of your sustenance. For all people. Zadur Rakib. That's why I said Karima bintul Karim, radiallahu ta'ala anha. Her cousin is Khalid al-Walid bin Bani Mahzum. Her cousin is also Abu Jahl. She narrates the hadith. Let me tell you quickly what she said. She said, Ja'far stood before me. The hadith is long, we'll talk about it again. Again. She said, Ja'far stood before the king of Abyssinia. He says, Ayyuhal Malik, O your majesty, kunna qawman ahla jahiliya. We were people of great ignorance before. Na'budul aslam. We worship creation. I don't want you to think worshipping idols only. Prescription. Worship creation. Creation could be idols, could be money, idols could be power, idols could be whatever it is. Other than the creator's idols, if people worship them. Na'budul aslam wa na'ti al-fawahish, and we do evil things. Remember, if you have no haya, fa'al. You do whatever. As long as nobody sees me, I can get away with it. I'll lie, I'll cheat, I'll steal, I'll deceive, I'll no problem. He says, لَتِ الْفَوَاحِجُ. Ja'far is speaking about what was Mecca before. Right? وَنَقْطَعُ الرَّحِمُ. And we are not good to our families. We don't give our families courtesy. And we're not good to our families. Our parents, etc., etc. Our children. Also, we're not good to our neighbors. We don't treat our neighbors. يَأْكُلُ الْقَوِيُّ مِنَ الضَّعِيفِ. The strong eats the weak. That's what Ja'far is saying. فكنا على ذلك حتى أرسل الله إلينا رسولا. We remained like this until Allah sent us a رسول from us. نعرف نسبه. We know who he is. And then look what Jafri said to you again. ونعرف صدقه وأمانته وعفافه. And we know his truthfulness. The man is trying, he's truthful. And we know his amana. You give him something, he will deliver what he promised. And عفافه. And we know that he doesn't cheat. فدعانا إلى الله. What did he call us to Allah? To worship him. نوحده. لا نشرك به شيئا. And then what to do? وأمرنا. What does the first thing that Ja'far رضي الله عنه says? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ordered. أمرنا بصدق الحديث. He asked us to speak the truth. Look, before he said صلاة صيام زكاة. We're not talking about صلاة صيام زكاة. He أمرنا بصدق. He told us we need to speak the truth. That's what a Muslim is known for. وأداء الأمانة. And that we actually fulfill the أمانة. Someone gave you أمانة, you fulfill it to the best you can. Otherwise, don't accept it. You accept it, you fulfill it now. وصلة الرحم. And he warned us to be good to our families. وحسن الجوار. And good to our neighbors. Look at that one. Do you see صلاة صيام زكاة here? ونهانا عن الفحش عن الفحشاء. And he forbade us from doing and saying evil. وأكل مال اليتيم. And eating the money by haram. وقذف المحصنة. And slandering the honorable women. And then he says وأمرنا بالصلاة والزكاة والصيام. And then he ordered us to do صلاة زكاة صيام. After all this, أم سلمة says فعدد مسائل الإسلام. This is what he named. Ja'far said what Islam was. This is what Islam was. This is what Islam is. If we are reversing the picture, we may be in trouble. I'm going to talk about it. Alhamdulillah.